Hi guys, today on my low sodium journey, the recipe of the day is going to be chicken fajitas. So come along with us, I'll show you how we make them. So I have a baseline recipe that I follow. One of the things that I think is important is that although this works for me, it may not work for you. Feel free to experiment in your kitchen. Feel free to say, I like this, I don't like that. But what we're going to do today is we're going to make a marinade. The marinade itself has a lot of sodium in it, but it has less than a quarter of what a normal marinade would have. And keep in mind that most of the marinade will be thrown away after we marinate the meat anyway. Okay, so I'll have Diana put a link down below to this recipe so you can try it for yourself. I'm going to be doing just over 2 pounds of chicken in this marinade because this is good. I like it cold. I like it hot. I'll eat it for days. So here we go. The first thing that we're going to be adding to this is a quarter cup of lime juice. That is our starting ingredient. So let's get that done. And you know, the measurements are kind of like guidelines anyway. So no big pressure there. We're also going to add a quarter cup of water to this mixture right off the bat. Okay, now the next thing that we're going to add is going to be a half a cup of sodium, low sodium soy sauce, or in my case, I'm going to be using a quarter cup of my coconut aminos and a quarter cup of low sodium soy sauce to this mixture. Remember, this is a low sodium diet, not a no sodium diet. That's the thing. And it's also important to recognize that this diet is my diet. It's not your diet. So anyway, here we go. We're gonna keep moving along here. So there's my base for what this marinade is going to become. We're gonna put in a tablespoon of olive oil because you need this marinade to stick to your chicken. This is 1 teaspoon of chili powder. If you want yours a little hotter, you can add a little more chili powder. You can add some cayenne pepper, anything like that that you may want. We like ours a little bit on the milder side. All right. Okay guys, so at this point, I'm almost down to my final ingredients. One of the things that's extremely important is, as I said, salt is a flavor enhancer. Well, you know what else is a flavor enhancer? Sugar. So if you're not on a diabetic diet, and you can have it, that's what I typically use to work my recipes up. In this particular recipe, I'm using brown sugar. And I know that looks like a lot, but it really isn't. All right, so we're mixing this up. At this point, with anything that you're making, you need to try it. If it does not taste good now, it is not gonna taste good when you put it on whatever it is that you're trying to cook. That's pretty good. I like that a lot. Okay, so there's our baseline marinade right there. We're gonna let these kind of meld together for a few minutes. We're gonna stir it up so we know the sugar is all infused, and then we'll move on to the next step. All right, so we've mixed our marinade together. We've stirred it, we've let it sit. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take just a little bit of this marinade, about that much, just a small container's worth. We're gonna keep that out. And why we're doing that is because when we cook our vegetables on the griddle, we're going to use that just as a last minute splash on, flip them through, and give them a little extra kick of flavor. The reason that we're doing this now is because I do not want any marinade that has touched raw meat to be used to cook anything else. One of the most important things you can do when cooking anything is remember that if you had a marinade that you used for 30 minutes or an hour or overnight, you don't want to use the remainder of that marinade for anything else. You need to just throw that away when you're done. So if you were going to make this, cut it in half and save it in the refrigerator for another time, making steak fajitas or something else, great. But do that while it is still clean before it becomes contaminated with raw meat. So moving on, we're going to get our chicken ready. All right, remember what we said, that meat and vegetables have salt in them naturally occurring. This raw chicken has 75 milligrams of sodium in it before I have done anything to it. Okay, so I've rinsed my chicken breasts because this is going to be chicken fajitas. And now I'm going to just basically pour the remainder of this marinade into this container. And I want to get it all as much as I can, because there's the good stuff, the sugar and the garlic is all down in there. So now I have placed this in this Ziploc bag and I've evacuated as much of the air out of it as I can. And I've massaged this marinade into this chicken. I'm going to have to put this in my refrigerator. And I'm going to tell you from the voice of experience, I've had this leak. And although it smells really good, you don't need your whole refrigerator smelling like this. So I always take a second bag and put it in there, because I'm going to marinate this chicken for about 24 hours in this mixture. Could you do it for less? Absolutely. You could probably even get away with just a few hours if you were in a hurry. But I happen to have the time. So there we go. So we'll pick back up with you when we're ready to cook it. So it's the next day. As many of you know, I have a 17-inch Blackstone griddle that I love to cook on that lives in Gumby. In fact, I liked it so much I bought a 22-inch Blackstone for the house. So tonight we're going to cook these chicken fajitas on the griddle so we can get that really good sear that we're looking for that gives us that flavor curve. So our chicken's been waiting overnight in the fridge, and here we go. I'm gonna cook these breasts whole, and then I will slice them as I'm about two-thirds of the way through the cooking process. Oh, they already smell amazing. So that is what I call contaminated marinade. It's had raw chicken in it overnight, so we're gonna throw that away. And of course, any marinade that's on the chicken is obviously going to cook off. So we'll do our vegetables. Voila. Got some red, yellow, and green peppers, and some onions, and we're just gonna kind of fry these up real quick. Just let them have at it. Check my chicken real quick here. 165, 165, 170, perfect. This is done. So this is that little bit of the marinade that we saved yesterday. What I call virgin marinade. It hasn't had anything done to it. And I'm just gonna take just a little bit of it and drizzle it over these vegetables here that are just about done sauteing. Just kind of give them an extra boost of flavor there. Should've got my big spatula. Guys, so there you go. This is our chicken fajitas, low sodium. We're gonna have a nice dinner, and we've got a lunch for tomorrow, and maybe some snacks. So you guys be safe, be well, and we'll see you with the next recipe.